Welcome to New Creation Women. We are so happy to be with you today. I'm Pastor Lorilee.
And I'm Pastor Patty. Welcome.
We're coming to you from the heartland of America, and we just want to invite you to get a cup of coffee or tea. Call in your sisters, your neighbors, your friends, and if you have your Bible, we'd like you to join us. We're going to do a little Bible study today on being new creatures. You know, our program, New Creation Women,
yes,
is about being a new creature.
Yes, it is.
It's based out of, we're using today the scriptures out of Colossians. So if you have your Bibles, you want to get Colossians chapter 3, and we're going to be reading verses 1 through 3.
Yes, and it's based out of when we talked about 2 Corinthians 5:17. Yes. Behold, we're new creatures in Christ. Old things have passed away and new things have come.
That's
what this program is about.
That's right. That's what our show is about, and that's what the program today is about. So if you have your Bible, please open it up to the book of Colossians, and we're going to be in chapter 3. Yeah. It says, since you have been raised to a new life with Christ, set your sights on the realities of heaven, where Christ sits at God's right hand in the place of honor and power. Let heaven fill your thoughts. Do not think only about things down here on earth, for you died when Christ died, and your real life is hidden with Christ in God. Pastor Patty, your version of the Bible might read a little differently, because I have the New Living Translation. How does your Bible read?
Yes, the Bible I use is New American Standard, actually the Open Bible, which you really can't even find anymore.
Yeah.
It's from 30 some years ago. So
wonderful.
Here's how this version reads. It says, if then you have been raised up with Christ, keep seeking the things above, where Christ is. He's seated at the right hand of God. Set your mind on the things above, not on the things that are on the earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God.
Yes, amen.
That's the version.
Amen, amen.
Yes.
And, you know, this reminds me, what occupies your thoughts? You know, I actually was doing something I read in a book about, I wrote down, you know, what's your priorities? Mm-hmm. So I put down what my priorities are, and then on the other side of the paper, write down what do you actually do.
Mm-hmm.
And it's very interesting if you see, like, what my priorities are: God, my husband, my family, the church, you know, then outside things. But then where do you actually spend your time?
Right.
And it's
right.
Interesting to see how your time is spent. If it's like doing a time inventory, and you know, and what fills our mind, or our thoughts, it can be really, you know, we can get very stressed about what's happening.
Mm-hmm.
And we talked about this, you know, having the joy of the Lord is
yes.
our strength, no matter what's going on
yes.
in our life. Because you can have trials and tribulations, don't we all?
Mm-hmm.
I know you're going through something very big right now with your brother. And I'm going through something in my family. But we can still have the peace
That's
of God.
Right. That's right.
No matter what's going on in our life.
Because the Lord doesn't change.
That's
the
right.
The circumstances shift left and right, up and down, but God changes not.
Amen.
And so as long as our focus and our thoughts and our hearts are directed to Him,
yes,
and to His Word and to that security that we know we have in Christ, it doesn't matter what kind of turmoil comes. He's always going to make a way where there seems to be no way.
That's right.
Yes.
That's right. And if we fix our mind on the things that are above,
yes.
it's not necessarily heaven, but Jesus and His promises. You know, we talked before about how this book is full of His promises, and you mentioned them. So then we don't get bound into fear. And just because you don't see something happening doesn't mean it's not happening, because sometimes... we don't see it. We've been praying and praying and praying, and that's why we want to encourage you today. If you've been praying for something and it hasn't come to pass, we want to encourage you. Don't give up.
Right.
Because that's what the devil wants us to just give up and say, you know what? I've been praying for this for so long. I'm not seeing it coming. I'm just going to give up and either go back to your old ways, or, you know, not go to church or not trust the Lord. But that would be the enemy. That's not the Lord.
No, that's not the Lord. And that's the spirit of defeat.
Yes.
we're not defeated. We're victorious.
Yes.
And a spirit of defeat would come in and say, "You're defeated. Just give up. It's never going to change. Right. Nothing new is going to happen." That spirit of defeat is already broken at the cross.
Amen.
And if we're seated, if I may,
yes,
the scripture
please.
Says, "If then you have been raised up with Christ." Well, we have been raised up with Christ.
Amen.
Okay.
Amen.
So keep seeking the things above where Christ is. Seated at the right hand of God. So we are with Christ already.
Yes.
He's seated at the right hand of God. We are with him. We're coming from a heavenly perspective. We don't have a spirit of defeat, or we don't have to worry about what is going to happen tomorrow and have fear come in because the Lord's already made a way. We're seated with him.
Yes. Yes.
Seated above. Above what? Above all the circumstances
everything that's going on. Yes.
And that's what we want to say today.
Yes. So it goes on to say in verse 5, "Put to death the sinful earthly things lurking within you. Have nothing to do with sexual sin, impurity, lust, shameful desires. Don't be greedy for the good things of this life, for that is idolatry." You know, because it's hard. And I know Pastor Patty and many women, you know, you might be a caretaker. You have mm-hmm. to take care of yourself, your parents or your children, or if you mm-hmm. have a spouse. And so many women are torn in so many directions. Mm-hmm. But, you know, the Bible tells us we need to take care of ourselves, and then mm-hmm. we can take care of other people. And I think that's a big problem for so many women. Mm-hmm. So a lot of women are caretakers, mm-hmm. and we're kind of brought up with, you know, doing that, and it makes mm-hmm. it makes it very tough. You can get drained and depleted, and then there isn't anything to give to somebody
right.
else. And that's where I see, you know, with mothers, so many mothers, you know, they have children, especially if you have multiple children, mm-hmm. and then they're all pulling on you and they're tugging on you, and the mothers get overwhelmed, and it's hard. And that's mm-hmm. it you're a grandma, you know, mm-hmm. you see it with
yeah.
our children and our grandchildren, and so Pastor Patty, how do you balance everything?
Well, I balance by putting asking the Lord to order my day. Prayer, worship, secret time spent with the Lord.
Yes.
And knowing that there are some things that may come in that are simply distractions. And I don't need to address those.
That's
because
right.
because they're coming to try to take away from the plan of God for my day.
Mm-hmm.
And so whatever God has planned for our days, we need to know that in our spirits. And so what I do is I do what the Lord really puts in front of me, and prioritizing. Pastor Lorilee is excellent at lists and prioritizing. You really are, because she writes down the things that are important. As she said earlier in this program, she writes them down and then she compares them. What did I really do? And those are important. So for myself, it's my quality time with the Lord and hearing from the Lord. It's that early morning hours of knowing. And then it's juggling everything else that comes in, but still knowing that it's not in my strength.
Yes.
It's in his strength.
Right.
It's not in my direction. It's in his leading. It's all about a personal relationship with the Lord and allowing him to truly be Lord
yes.
over the day and over our lives.
Amen. Amen. And there might be somebody watching out there that doesn't really know the Lord or doesn't mm-hmm. know anything. And we just want to give you an opportunity, if you don't know the Lord, to invite the Lord to come into
mm-hmm.
your heart,
mm-hmm.
to be the ruler of your life. You know, if I'm left to my own devices, mm-hmm. I'm going to do things that might not be in my best interest or the best interest of those that I love. But like you mm-hmm. said, every day I have to crucify myself. I have to ask God, help me, lead me, guide me, direct me mm-hmm. to do the next right thing.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it's the next right thing when you're getting bombarded. And sometimes mm-hmm. there's times in our lives when so many things just seem to be coming at us.
You're not kidding.
We have to just stop and say, like, you know, okay, Lord, what do you want? What is the
yes.
next thing that I need to do?
Yes.
And you're right. The devil will throw distractions mm-hmm. at us. And we
yes.
don't have to pick them up.
Yes.
Isn't
and
that?
not be afraid or in fear or be afraid of someone's reaction if we have to say, I can't do that right now. this is what I need to do right now. I am going to do that, but it can't be right now.
Right.
And not be afraid of man's or women's or a person's reaction to that, but knowing that maybe that's the best thing for you right now.
Yes.
You know, it's the best thing that we need to do right now. But we're going to take care of you too.
Amen.
So I think that's important.
Yes. One of my biggest things used to be a people pleaser. And I would be just make myself crazy trying to make sure my mother was okay, my husband was okay, my kids were okay. If you have a dog, you've got the dog to take care of. And you're just have all these things. And it would be so exhausting. Mm-hmm. I would be exhausted, and you can never make everybody totally 100% mm-hmm. happy. Mm-hmm. So the hardest thing for me has been learning to say, you know, like you said, no, I can't do that right now.
Right.
And being okay with somebody else's discomfort.
Exactly. Somebody else's discomfort. Not saying, I just had to do something like that this morning. I had to do something like that this morning. That's why it's fresh in my spirit. And I had to say, it's not that you're not important. It's not that this isn't great, but I cannot be distracted right now. We have to do a program, and I have to get ready for that program, because that's the assignment.
Yes.
That God said we had today was this these programs.
Yes.
And so we want to minister to you that way. So we don't want to come in and be distracted. We want to come in and give you what God wants you to have.
Yes. Amen. If you've never had an opportunity, just ask. You can repeat after me. Father, I ask you, Lord Jesus, to come into my heart. I'm sorry for any sins that I had committed before. Father, forgive me for my sins. I know you sent Jesus to die on the cross for my sins.
Yes, Lord.
And I know that, Lord, that you wash me clean. And Father, Lord, come into my life and help me, Lord. Give me your strength, Lord,
Thank you, Lord.
What I have to do, Father. And you be Lord of my life.
Jesus.
And I give my life to you in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
In Jesus'
name. Amen.
And if you did say that prayer, please write to us.
Yes.
We would love to hear from you, and we would like to know that this program is a blessing for you, and that we can send your prayer requests, and we'll pray for them, and we'll respond to you. So please, if you accepted Jesus Christ, let us know.
Yes.
Let us know.
And our website is also mm-hmm. there on the screen. You see the website, and you can write to us, and we do want to keep in touch
yes.
with you. We would like to hear praise reports, because
yes.
you know, this whole verse that we read today, it's about rising above.
Yes.
It's not about looking at your situation, whatever's going on, but it's about seeing things from God's perspective.
Yes. Yes.
You know, when you sit and when you're in heavenly places, it all looks different.
It does. It does look different. You know, I was looking at this scripture, Pastor Lorilee, verse 4.
Yes.
And it says, when Christ, who is our life, is revealed. We think that means, some people may think, or if we have a religious mindset, or if we're used to just a certain type of teaching, mm-hmm. we think that means when Jesus is coming back, that it's going to be revealed. But that's not what it says. It says, when Christ, who is our life, is revealed, then you also will be revealed with him in glory. I believe that's us inside.
Yes.
It's revealed
yes.
with him in glory.
Yes.
Filled with his glory, revealed in him with glory, in his glory. If Christ revealed in us is going to take care of all the other verses of scripture that Pastor Lorilee read about idolatry and everything
yes.
else, because Christ in us is the hope of glory. And he revealed in us is going to reveal himself through us.
Yes.
And so that's all about the new self, the new creation woman, raised up in heavenly places. He's revealed in us and through us.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We're so thankful that, you know, if I didn't have this Bible, really has come alive.
Yes.
You know, and if you don't have a Bible that you're not understanding, try it. You can even look online.
Yes.
You know, there's all kind of different
yes.
versions. But when I got this version, it just came alive.
Yes.
And it also has little notes in my Bible that relate it to everyday life.
Yes.
Because it's just one thing to read. And when I was growing up and in the Catholic tradition, we were taught to read the Bible, but mm-hmm. I was never taught to apply it to my life.
Mm-hmm.
I would read these things and it was like, oh, okay, and there's mm-hmm. the Ten Commandments and there's the fear of the Lord and blah, blah, blah.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't know how to adapt it to my
mm-hmm.
life. But when you have a Bible that you can, that comes to life yes. for you, and it helps you to live, because we have to overcome. You know, the word tells us to overcome.
Yes.
Like you said earlier, the devil tries to throw these things and distract us with all these things, but the word of God tells us that we're overcomers.
Yes.
And we can rise above whatever's going on, because the enemy will just have us think, oh my God, this is never going to end. This is my life. It's this big mountain in front of me. But that's not true.
No.
There is another side, and we have to go through as another...
to get to.
Yes.
Go through to get to.
The other
that's
side.
Right.
Yes.
That's
Amen.
Right.
Amen. Amen.
Well, maybe a quick example, Pastor Lorilee, for perhaps you that just accepted the Lord, or maybe you're new to Christianity faith, just a quick example, maybe a minute or so, of how you can apply, like taking a scripture, your day, like you get up and you read it and then you apply it.
Yes.
Can you do a quick maybe minute or so on how someone can just do that?
Well, let's look, if you look at verse 12 in same chapter, Colossians 3 verse 12, it says, since God chose you to be the holy people whom he loves, you must clothe yourself with tender-hearted mercy, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Okay, stop
yes,
right there.
Yes, yes.
Clothe yourself. That tells me I have to put it on.
Yes.
It's not something that I might... I don't naturally wake up in the morning clothed with mercy and kindness and gentleness, and especially, you know, once you turn your phone on, and there's sometimes people will rub you the wrong way.
Yes.
But we're not to respond. We're to clothe ourselves and respond in love and tender heart mercy. So I have to ask God. I read the scripture, then I say, Jesus, help me. Help me to put the clothes on so that I have tender hearted mercy and kindness and humility and gentleness and patience and love.
Yes.
You know, it goes on to say in verse 14, and the most important piece of clothing you must wear is love.
Yes.
Love is what binds us all together in perfect harmony.
Yes.
You know, if you don't have love, and I think it's in elsewhere in the scriptures, I know it's in Corinthians chapter 13 and talks about love, and if I don't have love, I'm just that clanging gong making lots of noise, and I could have the gifts of prophecy and all these wonderful things, but if I don't have love...
Right. And it says love never fails.
Yes.
That's the only thing in the Bible that says never fails.
Amen.
Love never fails.
Amen.
My version says, and beyond all the, in verse 14, and beyond all these things, put on love, which is the perfect bond of unity.
Ooh, I like
so
that.
So when we're walking through life or through our day, we have to know that if we want unity in our home, unity in our spirit, unity with those that we are ministering to or talking to, it's the perfect bond.
Yes.
What does it do? It bonds us together.
Yes.
As one. Jesus said, the Father and I are one, and you know, we're one, and he wants us to be one.
It reminds me when our daughter Kesha got married, her father-in-law is Jewish.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, they live in Israel. And so when we asked them to do a blessing at the wedding, her father-in-law said, now in the Hebrew word, and I don't remember what the Hebrew word was, but it said that they're stuck together like glue. They're glued together.
That's awesome.
Yes, and that reminds me of the same bond and, you know... Oh, life is, you know, it can be challenging, but it doesn't have to take us down. And we just want to encourage you today, no matter what you're going through, it doesn't have to be the final chapter. That's not the final chapter. Because the Lord promises us that he's going to be with us, and he will never leave us or forsake us, and he will give us his strength.
Yes.
You know, there was, I'm so thankful now that there's even these t-shirts. I was at Walmart the other day, and I got my grandson a t-shirt that said, I can do all things.
Oh.
It didn't have the whole scripture, but it said, I can do all things. And he said, Grandma, there's some famous sports guy, I don't know, one of these athletes. And that's what he says. I said, well, Zach, you know, it's in the Bible that I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. It's not me. I can't do all things on my own. Hello.
Yes.
By Christ in me, I can do all things.
Yes.
I can face tomorrow, whatever's going to happen.
And that's the difference from having the old life and the new life.
Yes.
The old life is depending upon ourselves, people, circumstances, a job, a situation, the new life is depending upon the Lord and leaning on Him for yes. everything. And that's why we're new creation woman, because this program is geared to helping women, men that watch it,
that's
children,
right.
to come out of where you are and to step into what God has for you.
Amen.
And that's what it's about.
Amen.
And transformation.
Yes, change. Yes.
Change.
It's about change. Oh, yes. That's not always easy, is it?
No, it's not.
Sometimes it's very hard, and I have to ask God to help
mm-hmm.
me, because we get comfortable, and sometimes it's even the fear of the unknown.
Mm-hmm.
We would rather stay in the situation that we're in, dealing mm-hmm. with what we have to deal with, because
yes.
we know that pain, than the fear of, uh-oh, I might have to change, I might have to try something
mm-hmm.
different.
Mm-hmm.
But they say pain is the touchstone for change.
Mm.
Sometimes it's like when you get in enough pain, then
mm-hmm.
you, okay, maybe I better try something different, because
mm-hmm.
what I've been doing hasn't been working.
Isn't working.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not working.
But mm-hmm. it's not easy, and we need Him. But it tells us here, you know, in verse 12, it says, God chose you to be the holy people whom He loves. He
mm.
chose us. And even it's in the Bible in 1 Peter 2:9. It says, you are my chosen one. He chose us. There's a
yes.
reason you're watching this program today.
Yes, yeah. yes.
It's just not a coincidence that you happen to stumble on this. You
no.
know, He has a purpose for your life.
Yes,
God has
yes.
a purpose, a
Absolutely.
Plan and a purpose. And like you said, what is my, every day we have to say, what is my assignment? And we
yes.
need to know our assignment, not only for the day, but for the week,
yes.
for the year. That's why it's good to do these,
mm.
you know, inventories and
mm.
and to take a time out.
And we have to realize that sometime we're so geared to, we want to plan our time. We want to plan
mm-hmm.
our day. And I've known people that have said, you know, this didn't happen, and it throws their whole day off. And instead of moving in these wonderful fruits that Pastor Lorilee mentioned, they begin to move in anger and resentment. And we don't want to move in anger and resentment. We want to allow God to put on a heart of love and accept what's coming in and know that regardless of what it is, God's going to order our day.
Amen. Amen. And sometimes we do have to be flexible.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you've known people that are so rigid
yes.
that they simply can't break their schedule because they have this schedule and they
yes.
can't do it. And you know what? They might miss out on something that God has
on
for them.
On a great blessing.
Yes.
On a great blessing. Yes.
So that's why we need the Holy Spirit. We
yes.
need to hear God's voice. Is this you, God?
Yes.
We want to, you know, make sure we want to go where He tells us
mm-hmm.
to go and do what
mm-hmm.
He tells us to do.
Mm-hmm. We should pray,
yes.
Pastor Lorilee. You should pray for some those that are watching that have that need to forgive. And one of the words that was coming to me was inventory. Not on a sad note, not on a bad note, but sometime, you know, that's that personal morning time that I have. I do an inventory, and I ask the Lord to change me, make me more like Him, and that I'm clothed with Him and His presence, His love. And so I just feel in my spirit that we need to pray that.
Go ahead, Pastor Patty.
You
can lead it. Thank you.
I would like you to just pray along with us now. Father, we just thank you for your blessing. We thank you, Lord, that you love us so much, that you give us all those spiritual blessings
yes.
in high places, Lord. Father, help us to look at those that perhaps, Lord, have hurt us, wounded us so deeply. And Lord, it's hard to release. And Father, you know the pain, but we make a choice, Lord, today. So if you're watching this program, just say, Lord, I make a choice. I choose to forgive.
Yes.
I choose to release those that I'm holding unforgiveness towards. I choose to bless them. Bless and curse
yes,
not, the Bible
you,
says.
Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
And just no matter, Lord, you're at their point of pain, so you understand it. So Father, in Jesus' name, help them. And just say, Lord, I want to do an inventory and I want to clear
yes.
everything out. It's
yes.
springtime here in Ohio, Campfield, Ohio. springtime. So springtime is spring cleaning. We just clean it all out right
Amen.
Now
yes.
in the name of Jesus. Give it to the Lord
Thank you,
and
Jesus.
Walk forward in power and victory.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And then when you do that, then you can let the peace of God come in and rule your heart and be in you. But
yes.
you have to clean out some stuff too. You know, we have to let go of the old to be able to take in
the new.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right. That's right.
And that's even in verse 15. And let the peace that comes from Christ rule your hearts. For as members of one body, we are called to live in peace and always be thankful.
Yes.
There's that word again, thankful.
Yes.
That gratitude list. You said,
yes.
I don't think I'm good at doing lists, but I do the gratitude list.
Yes,
I don't
do
those other lists every day, but I try to write down 5 things every day that I am grateful for.
You do a gratitude
I
list,
do.
And that's what I was addressing.
Yes. I do.
Yes.
I don't do all the other inventories and stuff, but it's good to do that.
Yes.
And
what
once
you're thankful
in a while.
For.
Yes.
Yes. Yes, absolutely.
Because it forces me then to focus on the good things.
Mm-hmm.
Because no matter how bad your day is, we can be thankful that we can get up out of bed.
That's
Because
right.
I know that there's people out there watching that can't get up. They might not be able to get dressed themselves.
No, I know someone like that that has to be taken care of all the time. And you know, it's not an easy thing.
No.
So, but we're so thankful that we have.
Yes.
We have these wonderful people watching today, Pastor Lorilee.
Yes, and again, we'd like to invite you to write to us. We want to hear from you. We want to pray for you. So please write. The address is on the web on the screen, info@newcreationwoman.org. Visit our website. And we do want to stay in touch with you so that we can pray for you.
Yes,
so
yes.
We have any final greetings, instructions? We've been talking about being new creatures. We are new creatures in Christ. The old has passed away. And we want to walk in peace and love and let the joy of the Lord fill us. We want to devote ourselves. You know, it tells us, that we want to just encourage you. If you don't know the Lord, to invite him into your heart, to get a Bible. You can go online. There's no excuse today.
Mm-hmm.
You can go on the computer. Most of you have internet, and you can get good reading scripture. So we just want to leave you with the love and the joy and the peace of the Lord. May he be in your hearts today. So Jesus, thank
Amen.
You. Amen.
God
thank
bless you.
You.
We love you.
We love you.
And tune in again.
Yes. See you soon. God bless.